Hello and welcome to my presentation about active learning for spreadsheet cell classification. My name is Julius Gonsio and I'm from the Technische Universität Dresden from Germany. Machine learning can be divided into two fields. The first one is supervised learning and the other big one is unsupervised learning. In a supervised learning setting, you first need to assign a label to each unlabeled data point. That has three major drawbacks. First, you need some human experts to label the data. It takes time for them to label it and it costs a lot of money. In contrast, in an unsupervised learning setting, you have much more data available, but you don't know the categories of them. There are several fields to make use of the unlabeled data in combination with the labeled one. For example, in a semi-supervised learning settings, you combine the labeled data and the unsupervised data during the training. In a weak supervised learning setting, you try to propagate the labels of a small ground truth dataset onto the unlabeled dataset. And while doing that, you may end up with some false labels, but because the majority will be correct labels, the idea is that it still helps. We are focusing on active learning, where you start with a really small label data set. Then the active learning algorithm decides which data point to label next. And a human oracle tells the active learning algorithm the real labels. And you repeat these steps iteratively until your end goal is reached. We've chosen a dataset which is really hard to label, which is spreadsheet cell classification. Therefore, we are not labeling spreadsheets per se, but we are labeling on the cell level. And the cells are classified into meta, header, and data cells. The dataset contained around 1,000 labeled spreadsheets and 100,000 data cells. And there were around 160 features describing the data cells, for example, the data type of the cell or the data types of the surrounding neighborhood cells, stuff like this. And the reason why we've chosen this dataset is because the average annotation time was 4.3 minutes per spreadsheet. So it seems to be a hard labeling task. And it would have been much better to have saved some time while labeling the data. A typical active learning setting is as follows. You start with a small labeled set L and a large unlabeled set. Then we train a classifier on the labeled set. Then we are asking the query strategy to order the unlabeled data set. And then depending on the batch size, we are posing the top n data points from the ordered unlabeled dataset to an oracle. Normally it's a human, but in our case it's a gold standard. And after that we append the newly retrieved labels to the old label set and the whole cycle starts again. And during each cycle we calculate so-called stopping criteria. And depending on the outcome, we might end the active learning cycle early. The goal for this project is to find out which parameters of active learning algorithms exist and what are good values for them. The query strategies we've tried out are first random sampling as a baseline, then the really popular uncertainty sampling ones, where you are using the probability or the confidence of the classifier to choose the most uncertain point to label next. We've compared least confidence, the smallest margin between the two most closest classes, and the end entropy. And then we've chosen the query by committee strategy, where you're using a committee of multiple classifiers, and then you're doing a majority vote on them. We've used naive Bayes, support vector machines, decision trees, and random forest. The batch size just defines how many data points you're posing to the Oracle. It's either a fixed value or a problem specific, semantically reasonable amount. Like in our case, these are all cells from one spreadsheet. Because it's really hard for a human annotator to open 100 spreadsheets and then to just label one cell from each spreadsheet, so it's much more better for the annotator to open one spreadsheet at a time and to then label all the spreadsheets from it. So then he doesn't need to pass the content of the spreadsheets all over again and again. The stopping criteria are for the question, can we stop the labeling process early? First, we're taking the uncertainty into consideration, so the probability of the classifier while labeling the data. And if the uncertainty of the classifier decreases, we can stop early. Then the selected accuracy, that is the accuracy of the last batch of queries which got proposed to the Oracle. And because this value fluctuates quite a lot, the standard deviation of the last 5 accuracies is taken into account as well. Let's take a look at the results of our experiments. The results for the start set size show that it doesn't really matter with how many percent of the start of the labeled dataset you start. And therefore you can just use a really, really small set as your starting point. And the dotted line is a passive classifier, so a classifier which is trained on all the labels at once. Then the batch size. Here as well, we couldn't really find big differences between them. It's just that a batch size on spreadsheet level there, the results aren't fluctuating as much as for the other ones. And therefore, we can advise to use the sheet-wise batches because it makes the task for the annotators much more easier. The sampling strategies are probably a little bit more interesting. The random one is the worst, of course. And then the uncertainty ones, they are quite similar. But the comity one is most of the time a little bit better. The stopping criteria, the max uncertainty one, is almost the same the whole time and only drops in the end. And so it's better to take a look at the selected accuracy, but it fluctuates a lot. So one way to stop early is to look for one peak in the selected accuracy. And if after this peak, the standard deviation drops, then we can stop again. In the future, we want to include weak supervision directly into the labeling process because we believe this can drastically reduce again the labeling effort while maybe even increasing the accuracy. An example, one could automatically label the most certain data points without asking the Oracle. Or you could cluster the data first, and then if you have like one cluster where you know that all the labels you have for this cluster are the same, and you have already 70% of this cluster labeled, then you can propagate the labels to the whole cluster. And then reinforcement learning or imitation learning seem promising to learn new active learning strategies. And for the imitation learning, you need an expert which teaches the algorithm the next best moves. And that means in our case, we peek into the future with brute force, testing out all possible next moves. So in conclusion, we successfully applied active learning on a real world data set. Our overall goal was to reduce the human interaction, and we could have reduced it by quite a lot. And our recommendations are start with a really like the smallest possible start set size, use a batch size, which makes it easier for the annotator to work with the data. You can use committee or uncertainty sampling, and it's best to use a combination of the stopping criteria. Thanks for your attention.